Now that we have learned how to analyze algorithms, let's look back to the algorithm that Alice was using to solve her problem, which was the whole point of us learning about algorithm analysis in the first place. So here again is the algorithm that Alice was using. It's those five lines here. And although we already noticed that it's a running time that grows exponentially, we don't really yet have the precise running time stated in O notation. So in order to do this, let's look at the individual lines and see how often they are executed. And then as a little quiz, I will ask you to figure out the running time of Alice's algorithm using O notation. So let's start with line one. And line one is just an assignment of a value. So that's actually, it takes zero time steps, but we can also just say that it takes O of one time steps, which just means that it's some constant. Although in this case, the constant is zero, but O of one is a general notation to keep in mind. Anytime you want to state that an algorithm runs in constant time, you can just write O of one. Now, line number two, when we have n communication centers, so n is going to be the size of the input in this case, then we already figured out at the beginning that this line here is going to be executed O of 2 to the power of n times. And I'm going to use this notation here, which you might not be familiar with, to say that n here is the exponent. So what about line number 3? So line number 3 is going to be called each time that this loop here executes. So each time the loop of lines 2, 3, 4, and 5 executes, we're going to call this function here. Now, the question is, how long does it take us to check if an assignment of 0 and 1 values is valid? So if you have a network that has n communication centers, then in theory, each communication center can be connected to any other communication center. So you have n communication centers. And the question is, how many connections can they have between each other? So this one could be connected to this one here, and so on. And basically checking if an assignment of 0 and 1 values is valid means checking for each cable between two communication centers whether at least one of the communication centers is assigned a 1. So the running time of checking if the whole assignment of 0 and 1 values is valid depends on the total number of cables. So the question here is, what is the maximum number of cables that we can have? And that is actually very similar to the running time of the algorithm that you analyzed in the quiz a few minutes ago, because the first communication center can be connected to n minus 1 other communication centers. Then the second one, it can also be connected to n minus 1 other centers, but of course we don't want to double count, or actually it doesn't really matter if we double count or not because we're using O notation, but if we don't double count, then it's just n minus 2 cables here. And this goes on and on and on. And from the algorithm that you analyzed before when we were discussing O notation, you already know that if you do the sum of n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3, and so on until you get down to 1, then that is O of n squared. The worst case running time for checking if a given assignment is valid means going through O of n squared different cables, and then for each of those cables checking if one of the communication centers that it's attached to has been assigned a 1. Now, to figure out the running time of this line here, of course we first know it's O of n squared cables, and then the question is, how much time do we need to check an individual cable? But for now, I think without further discussion, we can assume that it's constant time because it's just connected to two communication centers. So there's probably an efficient way that we can implement this. If you were to prove the actual running time, of course, you would have to have a more detailed discussion here. But for now, we'll just say each time this line here is executed, it takes O of n squared time. Now, what about line number 4? Each time this line is executed, we have to do the sum of all the ones in the assignment. And now the assignment concerns the communication centers. So we have to go through n communication centers and count how many ones we find. So each time this line is executed, it will take O of n time, which is linear time. And finally, line number 5, it's taking the minimum of the best possible solution we have found so far and the number of devices we have in the current solution to figure out if the current solution is a better solution than the one that we already have. But this, of course, takes only constant time because it does not depend on the size of the input. It always takes two values and produces a minimum. So as announced, as our next quiz, I would like you to take this information and figure out what the overall running time of Alice's algorithm will be given a network of n communication centers. So which of these six possibilities is the correct running time of Alice's algorithm above?